Stop! I'm David Camp, PhD, and in this video I discuss why do you feel so jealous about her sexual history? Welcome to Man Up, episode 156.
Masculinity for the intelligent man. I'm David Tien, PhD, and this is Man
Up! Hi, I'm David Tien, PhD, and for over the past 10 years, I've been helping hundreds of thousands of people in over 87 countries attain success, happiness, and fulfillment in life and love. And here I am in Bangkok, and just walking out from the Luxury Collection Hotel here. And it's really cool because it's actually connected directly through the sky bridge to the BTS. So just swing around, you can see, I mentioned in an earlier episode how all of Bangkok, well, not all, but a big part of Bangkok for in this area from Sukhumvit down a couple stations that way, and then starting up again about two stations over, starting from there and going about four stations, they're all connected by these like sky bridges. Well, it's not bridges, it's like sky platforms. I forget the exact term for it. And then up above there, you can see it's called the BTS or above ground subway here. So it's pretty cool, very comfortable living here. And this particular hotel connects right through to the subway. So you can see the platform, I just walk all the way out. Very convenient. Anyway, this is not a hotel review, but I just wanted to show you that. And I'm gonna show you a rush hour traffic here. One thing about Bangkok and Jakarta, is the horrible traffic. This is what, like 5:30 p.m. So it's not even that bad yet. But everyone who's been out here, you know what I'm talking about, the horrible traffic. There you go, there's some more. All right, so I'm gonna go a little quieter area over here, and I'm answering a question. Actually, I'm answering quite a few guys had the same question over the period of about a week or so, and it was about basically the same issue, and it was that, why is it that they're asking, why is it that when the girlfriend or the girl I'm seeing has had more sexual experience than I have, or is getting more attention from guys than I am getting attention from girls, why do I feel jealous? Why is there this overwhelming feeling of jealousy? So I'll give you three quick reasons for this. The first is to understand the science in evolution. So from an evolutionary perspective, it just makes sense if you find out that a woman, I'm just gonna make this message disappear, if you find out that a woman has had a lot of sexual partners, that you'd find some degree of insecurity around whether you can trust because of the paternity uncertainty. So it's not clear whether, if you have a baby with her, whether it's yours, and so you doubt this. And so from an evolutionary perspective, it warns you not to invest too much. Okay, so just to understand this from a pure science perspective, it just sort of makes sense. There's a great book by David Buss, a scientist in evolutionary psychology. It's just, I think it's called like, one of the words in the subtitle or the title is jealousy. It's not that hard to find. There's some scientific research in anthropology that says that we came from tribal societies, where in tribal societies, to counteract the paternity uncertainty, women took a mating strategy where they hooked up with multiple men so that the men never knew if that was really their child, so that basically they invested in all of the children in the tribe, in the village or whatever, and raised them all up because just in case, you know. So I think that originally 50,000 years ago, the tribes were not that big. 50,000 years ago, we weren't in large communities yet. And if we understand evolutionary lag, what we're adapted for, it's about 50 to 100,000 years roughly. And at that time, we traveled in groups of like 10 to 15 people, 15 at most roughly. So this is my knowledge of anthropology, paleoanthropology. So if anybody who has knowledge that differs from that, please feel free to talk about that in the Man Up group. But it just sort of makes sense from an evolutionary perspective why you'd be jealous when you find out that a woman that you've invested time into has a history of sexual promiscuity. Just makes sense. It makes you, it's actually evolutionarily useful to you to sort of like, it's a red alert, like, okay, hold on, let's make sure we don't overinvest just in case she cheated on you or something like that. And then beyond that, just because it's evolutionary adaptive, doesn't mean that it's a good thing, right? It's just to understand why you feel that way. But beyond that, in terms of human psychology, the more you invest in something, the more it becomes worth to you. So this is what I talk about in many of my programs called the cost-worth connection. So the more it costs, the more worth you ascribe to it. So the more you invest in a girl or a woman, the more that you will feel jealous when you find out that maybe she had maybe she was sexually promiscuous, or that maybe she liked some other guy. So one of the other examples was one of my girlfriend is a huge fan of, I forget which star it was, maybe it was Channing Tatum or whatever, and she drools about him and like fantasizes about him and all this, and he's like, I feel insecure or jealous when this happens. How do I deal with that? And so that's the same sort of issue. That is less of an evolutionary explanation. It's more of an investment issue where you put a lot into this, and maybe if he shows up, maybe she'll throw everything out the door just for him. But beyond that, actually, in that case, it's a really good segue. The deeper reason. So at the surface level, there's investment. But if you're equally investing in a good relationship, you're equally investing. So that you shouldn't be over-invested, so to the point where you're like pot committed, or whatever the term is, like in poker, where you went too far into that hand and you lose all rationality. If you have equal investment, mutual investment, you invest in her, she invests in you, you shouldn't feel that much insecurity, because it's your, the investment should be matched and it should be equal, what you both put into it. So that should mitigate that insecure feeling. So it really comes down to the third, which is the self-worth issues. And this I went into in much detail, in a lot of detail, in the live shows I shot, in the Facebook group that I was doing for a couple weeks, and then I might do again, depending on how much engagement we get. As we go forward, but it got a lot of engagement. We had hundreds of guys watch those videos. I think the last count, we had like 900 or 1,000 on the first video. So go watch the live shows inside the Facebook group. But I went into deep into the self-worth issues and the codependency. So that like the investment with a woman that you put into a woman, even if she invests back in you, you still might not appreciate that. It's still mentally, psychologically, you still may not be able to draw strength from it, because of your codependency issues. So I go into that in a lot of detail in the live shows. Of course, there's a lot more to say about it, but I go into more detail in the live shows. In addition to codependency, there's your whole self-esteem and self-worth problems. They're all related. So guys who exhibit a really obsessive level of jealousy, where it nags at them to a degree where it's like almost neurotic, that's beyond the evolution or just investment, the first two points I made. That's where it's at the level of their self-worth issues, the worthiness issues, their self-esteem issues. And they're probably in a codependent relationship with that woman or that girl. And unless you deal with that underlying issue, then this jealousy is never gonna go away. Even if you were to, like what a lot of guys try to do, and a lot of POAs and game guys try to do to counteract the jealousy, is to, like, there's some acronym for it, but some basically like, so go fuck 10 girls or something. They just basically want to just like make themselves feel, their ego feel good by getting the same attention that she's getting, but he's going to get it from girls and he's just going to prop his ego up. A very bad and dangerous strategy. It's actually going to just actually drive the issues deeper into your psyche, and it'll be actually make it harder for you to access them while this is happening. So it'll actually prolong the pain, in fact. So and it's like an addiction, in fact, like that low self-esteem, low self-worth. So. Get that fixed. That's the underlying issue. So I go into that detail on that in the live shows. Get into the Facebook group to access those live shows. My arm is now shaking a bit. I did a heavy workout today, counteract some of that birthday eating. So I'm gonna end the video here. So just to recap, why do you feel obsessively jealous about your girlfriend's sexual history or the attention she gets from guys? Evolution. Overinvestment, possibly, that you're overinvestment from you. And then finally, very likely in all cases, self-worth issues, self-esteem issues, codependency issues. And I cover the third one in a lot more detail in the live shows inside the Facebook group. So join the private Facebook group. Click the link, join the group, and I'll see you inside the group. Until then, man up.